What's up, dogs? I packed the tent. I packed the bag. I packed the axe. And I packed only the Canon RF 24-105 F4 LIS USM. What a horribly long name. I'm rocking the RP. We're filming on that right now. And you're here wondering if this lens is better than the other 24-105 kit lens and whether in fact it can do it all. The answer is a resounding yes, and I have the pics from my camping trip to prove it. And now for the good, the bad, and the ugly. Let's get into the good and buckle up because thankfully there's a lot here to cover. We've got an L lens here, boys and girls, and this is one of the two that I use. The EF 100mm macro and I have a special relationship, but the 24-105 I love almost as much. It's not the classic mostly metal construction that we see in the older EF L lenses. The RF line has kind of moved away from that in order to conserve weight, but it has a premium feel and a weather sealing gasket around the mount. Second, this is an image stabilized lens with 5 stops of image stabilization, and that makes a huge difference. The image stabilization is likely a big chunk of what you're paying for here, and it complements the fact that this is an F4 and not an F2.8. And speaking of, the F4 is constant throughout the focal range. That's the major difference between this lens and the other version of the RF 24-105, where it's a dark and lonely 7.1 at the end of the telephoto range. I don't do a ton of video work with this just yet, mostly just YouTube, but this is great news for video shooters. Even at F4, you can get some decent bokeh on the long end, even though you might not traditionally associate that look with something like an F4 lens. Dad autofocus is incredibly fast and nearly silent, and the zoom range is impressive, going from a sort of wide 24 to a telephoto-ish 105. This long range is what makes it possible to pack only this one lens for a travel trip and feel relatively confident that you're gonna have all your bases covered. And this 24-105 is actually my first kit lens. When I got the Rebel T7i, I decided to forego any of the kit lens options, jumped right into the nifty 50, and soon thereafter, the EFS 24mm. In doing so, I was able to cover 2 different focal lengths without having to suffer through poor image quality as I learned more about photography. Definitely do not associate any negative connotation of kit lens with this RF 24-105. It's generally said that a zoom lens like this is good at everything and not awesome at any one thing. And I would agree. However, this kit lens is great at everything while not being amazing at any one thing. It really shows you the promise of the RF lineup. Grabbing the RP is an affordable way to step into the Canon RF full frame series and start to invest in glass that will work on your next body. Now onto the bad, but real quick, my name is Dan Joshua and I'm a creative entrepreneur. I'd love to help you learn, make, and monetize your photography and creative projects because that's exactly how I spend my time. Please join me by simply subscribing. Now this lens is a bit of a chunker. It's not massive, but it's a little less convenient to carry around on, say, a 12-mile hike than the RF 35mm 1.8 would be, which is what we're filming on right now. But for the coverage of an excellent zoom range, I think that's a fair price to pay for what you have. Additionally, because it's an external zoom, this packs in your bag in a relatively small footprint. I recently got a Peak Design capture clip, and that worked great for hands-free on our hike, and the plate is compatible with their tripods. Now the F4 might be a turnoff for some, and of course I would prefer a 2.8. As an intermediate shooter though, I cannot swing the $2,300 24-70. And when shooting outside or when shooting for YouTube with a cheap softbox, I don't really need the F2.8. The big brother would certainly be helpful for shooting indoor gigs, and you're probably not going to use this too often for wedding shooting, at least not paired with the RP. Using this for paid indoor gigs is going to be much more achievable with bodies like the R5 and R6 that have IBIS and even better low light performance. But if you can swing the R5 or R6, you also likely can swing one of those high-end zoom lenses that shoots at f2.8. All in all, this lens is $2,100 when packaged with the RP, and I think that's a fair price for what you're getting. It especially shoots Canon shooters coming from crop sensor bodies that might have some better EF glass that they've already invested in. If you want to get into the RF lineup for cheaper and want to do so while avoiding the less exciting 24-105, you can do so by picking up the 35mm or the 50mm coming out in December 2020. Those options would run you approximately $1,500 or $1,250 respectively. Finally, let's get to the ugly. Just kidding, there's no ugly whatsoever. So how does this stack up as the sole lens that you would bring on a travel trip? The one use case that I felt I wanted faster than an F4 was for astrophotography. Typically, you wouldn't think of F4 as too usable there, but even on the entry-level RP that uses the RF mount, it handles noise pretty well. While on a tripod and at the wide end, you can get away with a long exposure. So this shot was F4, ISO 2000 for 15 seconds. If I had an F1.8, and I'm doing my math correctly, I could have taken the same shot and dropped the ISO to around 400. Or I could have kept the ISO high and dropped the exposure time to around 4 seconds in order to get more definition in the clouds rolling in. At F4, astro shots like this one are just hard. At 25 seconds, I'm seeing the stars move, so you can't stay open quite that long, and ISO is already cranked to 6400. I also wanted to go even wider. I'd love to try this same type of shot with the Canon 14mm f2.8. Otherwise, besides for astro, this lens slaps. I was happy with the other shots that I decided to pull into Lightroom, and I never felt sad that I didn't have another lens in my bag. In my EF 100mm macro review, I talk about liking this as a walk-around lens on a hike, so that I can use that macro capability, and so that I can take portraits of people from a distance without interrupting. When I bring this, I can always take my wide shots on my phone, but it's nice to have that full 24-105 zoom range so that I can take nice, wide shots on a RAW that I can then pull into your Lightroom.